What's up, guys? It's Mr. Levi Sir here, and today I'm bringing you another video on Defiance. We're going to be talking about weapon mastery and nano effects. And yeah, first of all, with weapon mastery, let's see here. Pretty much, it's just this this white bar fills up underneath your weapon stats, and it once you get it full, you kill enough enemies, you'll get a permanent perk. And it's, for this particular weapon, it's plus 3% damage from above. So anytime you're higher than an enemy, you'll do 3% extra damage. And they vary from weapon to weapon. Like this one here, it's plus 15% rate of fire for 5 seconds after self-revive. And yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory. Just kill enough people with the same weapon, and you'll receive a permanent upgrade. And it's pretty cool. Yeah, so let's move on to nano effects. And I'm going to start with electrical and incendiary, and pretty much both of those will stun your enemy for a limited amount of time. Personally, I prefer the electric, and that's just because it keeps the enemy right in place while they're being electrocuted, and they're not running around moving, and I can just continue to unload on them. With the incendiary, once they catch on fire, they'll kind of run around and freak out a little bit, and I just I prefer them to stay right put. But yeah, let's see these in action real quick here. Start with the electrical. As you can see, it just takes them out nice and smooth. Once the weapon or takes the nano effect takes a place, you'll see they'll take like damage over a certain amount of time, and they'll be stunned for a little bit. Switch it up to incendiary here. Catch some enemies. Apparently nobody wants none of this. Oh, here we go. Boom. And at this point in time, there's no enemies who are susceptible to a certain type of damage, which kind of sucks because I'd like it to be a little more tactical, I guess. But yeah, this here you see. Oh, here we got the new enemies they inputted into the game. We got electrical hell bugs here now. You got all of the hell bugs except corrosive. I think it just sticks with the radiation. And see, and this is what happens when you get hit with electrical. Your HUD goes out. You can't shoot right. You gotta fire from the hip. But as you can see, I'm using electrical right now on the electrical hellbugs, and it's not canceling out damage or anything like that. It's just, it's doing the same amount of damage it normally would. Let's see if I can get a second here to switch it up to the other. Here, take this break. Boom. Okay, biological and siphon is what we're working with now. The biological, it'll slow the enemy. It kind of puts that tar or sludge looking substance on them, and it's pretty similar to the bio grenades. I'm pretty sure most of you have used those. And yeah, I personally don't know what it is about the sound the gun makes when it's shooting the biological, the nano, but I just don't like it. And it doesn't seem to be too useful, in my opinion, as far because it slows them down, but only just for a second. You know, it doesn't do too much. Moving on to siphon here, this it's kind of like life drain. It'll take your enemy's shield and replenish yours. It won't replenish your life, but it will replenish your shield. And it doesn't do it with every shot. It's every 25 shots or so, it'll just take a little bit. And yeah, the siphon's pretty cool when you have some sort of nano effect increase, perk on or anything like that. You're taking damage, you just light them up, and as you can see, it kind of replenishes your shield. Let's let the enemy see if it, yeah, here we go. Go behind him. Well, my oh damn it, I can't show you. Alright, but yeah, that's pretty much what it does. And lastly, we have corrosive and radiation. And the difference between the two is the corrosive is kind of like a poison. It'll damage them over time. See if maybe we can get some more people to spawn here. It'll damage them over time, while as the radiation will weaken their shields. See, here's radiation. These guys don't even have any shields, so it doesn't really matter. So, I mean, it's more effective against, like, the 99ers, Dark Matter, that kind of stuff. Or the new enemies they brought in, the Rogue E-Rep soldiers. It's more effective against them. The Corrosive, on the other hand, once it takes effect, it will just, like I said, it'll be kind of like poison damage, and it'll just damage them over, you know, for a few seconds. Yeah, let's see if I can't show you guys that in action here. Help me up! And the nice thing about the Corrosive is you can actually get weapon mods called the Toxic Shock Converter. And, you know, it comes for the... As far as I know, it comes for every weapon besides the detonators, the rocket launchers, and the infectors. But it's really nice once you get it on like a saw or a assault rifle, fully automatic, and you just unload the corrosive, because it'll eat through their shield and damage them over time if they if the effect takes place. Here we go. But yeah, I hope that helps, guys. It's pretty much nano effects in a nutshell. If you guys have any other questions or you want to see any other videos, let me know. I'll do my best to get those up. And yeah, next I'll be doing weapon mods and synergies. Hope you guys enjoy the video. Please like and subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll see you guys later.